Hello students, so we are revising our topics force. In that we yesterday have seen what are contact and non-contact forces along with their examples and their types. So contact forces, we have seen that there are muscular forces and frictional forces, and in non-contact force we have seen that magnetic force, gravitational force and electrostatic force are the three different types of forces that are existing on this earth. So today we shall move on to balanced and unbalanced force. Now let us try to understand what are balanced forces and unbalanced forces. So for this thing we can perform an experiment. What you have to do is, we have to take up a cardboard box, tie tight string to its two sides and keep it on a smooth table, and then take the string on both sides of the table and tie weighing pan, you know, like that taraju which is used, earlier it was used, nowadays everybody is having digital weighing machine, but earlier or sometimes somewhere you can observe also with the vegetable vendors or kirana shops, the weighing pans are used of equal masses at both the ends. So you can do this at home also with the help of, if this is the table, here is this box, what you can do is tie a string and here proper pans can be fitted to the boxes from both the sides, and if whatever weight that will be fitting in those pans, the amount of weight that you are going to put, how much it is, that will decide which way it is going to twist. So the box does not move on the table, that we know. If more mass is kept in one of the pans and less in the other, in that case the box starts moving in the direction of more weight, where now that side more weight is there, the box will slide from the table to that side. On the contrary, if more mass is kept in one of the pan than the other, the box starts moving in that direction of the pan with more mass. But if we keep equal amount of masses, weights on both the pans, the box will not be moving. So equal gravitational force acts on both the pans when equal masses are kept in them. But if one pan is having more weight and the other one is having less weight, the box will move towards the more weight side pan. Okay, when equal forces are applied to the box on the two sides, an unbalanced force acts on the box, resulting in imparting motion to the box. Now you can see I have put more bigger weight in this pan and smaller weight in this pan. In that case, obviously this box will be pulled in this direction. And we can find, because of unbalanced force acting on the box, it tends to be in motion. It will come into motion. It will move towards the direction of more weight. But if we are going to take same amount of weight in both the boxes, in that case, the box is not going to move. So when balance force is there, if balance forces acting on the box, it will not be showing any motion. Unbalanced force is responsible for motion. Balanced force is not responsible for stationary object. Are you getting balanced and unbalanced force? For this, more examples earlier also we all have discussed about children playing tug of war. You all must have played it sometime in the school, where a rope is being pulled in two directions by the two groups, isn't it? And if the pull of the force is equal from both the sides, means 10 members here and 10 members to the right and 10 members to the left, in that case, and that two having equal forces on both the sides, the rope will not move. Okay, but if on one side there are more strong people and they will move, pull the rope with more force, in that case, you will be seeing that the rope moves in that direction. This means that initially the two forces are balanced. The rope moves in the direction of higher force, and when the force becomes unbalanced. So anytime, anywhere, only the unbalanced force is responsible for motion. Balanced forces are not going to show any motion. Okay. So more example, if you want, when big grain storage container is required to slide on the ground. At home, you must be having big storage containers of grains like rice and wheat. Now, if you want to move it from one place to another, it becomes easier if two persons are pushing it rather than only one person. You ask for help to your brother, sister, because it will be becoming easier if somebody is going to help you. And when the force is applied by both in the same direction, okay? So you see, if this is your, say, a container or a box of grains, which is having a loop also to hold the tight like this, in that case, if one person is only pushing, in that case, it will not be easily moved. But one more person, your brother, sister also comes up to help you, and both are working in the same direction, in that case, it becomes easy to slide this box of grain on the floor, and the movement is easy. Isn't it? But if your brother, sister, younger one is a little mischievous, and if they push from the other side, if somebody is pushing from this other side, you can imagine what will happen. Both the forces will counter each other and the box may not move if they have equal forces. Now, the bigger brother is having more force, so the box will little bit move there, and the younger brother having less force, so, but then also he will try to stop the movement done by the elder brother, isn't it? So, there are three postulates, three things that you have to remember related to balanced and unbalanced force. If several forces are applied on an object in the same direction, a force equal to their addition acts on that object. So, in earlier situation, we have seen that the two brothers are pushing in the same direction. Suppose now the elder brother is applying 10 Newton force, and younger brother is applying 5 Newton force. So how much force in all is applied on this box is 15 Newton. Addition of these two forces. So the box is moving on the floor with the force 15 Newton. So this is going to make the work easy. Okay. Now, if two forces are applied on an object in direction opposite to each other. Now, this younger brother is little mischievous and he went to the other side of the box and was pushing the box from the opposite direction from that of your elder brother. In that case, you can understand what will happen. The box will definitely move in that direction only, but the force will be reduced by 5 Newton. 10 minus 5, that is 5 Newton. Now it is moving only with the force of 5 Newton. Why? Because the younger brother is pushing from the opposite side. Okay, so here you will be doing subtraction. The difference acts on the box or the object. Okay, now a force is expressed in magnitude and direction. Therefore, we all know that force is a vector quantity. Force is a vector quantity. Why? Because it do have magnitude with direction. There is magnitude plus direction. If direction will not be there, then that quantity becomes a scalar quantity. Only magnitude is there, but no direction. In that case, it becomes a scalar quantity, but our force is a vector quantity. Remember all this, very important. When a force is applied on a stationary object, it moves definitely. Its speed and direction can also be changed. If we apply more force, with more speed it will be moving. If we want to change the direction, we will twist and will push in the other direction. So direction can be changed. Okay. So similarly, a force is required to stop an object also. So these are all the effects of force. What are all the effects of force? Very important points. Effects of force applied. When you apply any force, stationary object moves. Stationary object starts moving. Okay, this is the first effect of force that we can see. Its speed and direction can also change. Because of applied force, change in speed and direction can be brought about. Okay, then what more you can see? A force is required to stop any moving object. Stops moving object. Okay, to stop any moving object also, we need force. Okay, an object can change its shape due to force. Fourth effect. Change of shape. We all have discussed that when mother needs the dog, okay, change in shape is brought about in the dough that she prepares for making chapati. Earlier, the dough is like a big ball, and then it small part is taken, and with a roller, it is flattened into a chapati. So that is an example of shape changing due to applying force. Now, a potter applies a force in a specific direction while shaping the pot. So differently shaped pots are available in the market, oval shape, round shape, isn't it? Then a rubber band. Rubber band, everybody knows, when stretched and expanded and when released, it will come back to normal position. So these are all examples of change in shape due to force. So force has so many effects on the objects. Stationary object can come into motion. Speed and direction can be changed. You all are riding a bicycle, so you know how to change the speed by pedaling more and applying more force. And you can change the direction by moving the handle, isn't it? So there also you are applying force. Now, if something is moving like a football, if it is moving, you can stop it with your feet. That there also you are applying the force. And shape changing daily your mother is doing in the kitchen, making chapatis out of that dough. So this is the best known examples for effects of force that we have studied now. Now next topic that we are going to discuss today is inertia. What is inertia? Inertia is the tendency of any object to remain in the existing state. Okay, whatever object. Now the book is kept on the table, it will stay as it is. It will not move from its position unless and until I apply my force and pick it up. Okay, so that is inertia definition, the tendency of any object to remain in the existing state. Okay. Now, we have seen that an object changes its state of motion due to applying force only. It is brought about by force only. And in the absence of force, objects exhibit a tendency to remain in the existing state of motion. If no force is applied, the thing will be as it is kept. Okay. In this, we can see with certain examples. For example, a postcard. If we keep a postcard on a glass and keep a 5 rupee note, or 5 rupee coin, sorry. This is a postcard. If we keep a 5 rupee coin on this, okay? This you all must have done at home also. And now skillfully push the card. This card should be tactfully pushed or pulled with a speed. We are applying force to remove the postcard. In that case, you find the coin. This will get removed and the coin directly falls into your glass. Now, how it is happening? The coin is not moving, not going to change its existing state, even though we are removing with a speed this postcard. Another example, you can hang a half a kg mass to a stand with a string and tie another string to the mass and keep it hanging. Now, what we can do is pull the string number 2. This is any object. One string, string number 1, string number 2. What we are going to do? String number two, we are going to pull with a jerk. This string we are going to pull with a jerk. In that case, you see the string one breaks and the mass falls down. This is because the tension developed in the string two does due to the mass that is occurring over there. Okay, so this is where we going to start and understand different types of inertia. So what is inertia? The tendency of any object to remain in its existing state. And this is why an object in stationary state remain in the same state and an object in motion remain in its state of motion in the absence of any external force. If no force is going to act, the object will remain as it is, either in motion, either in stationary position. So different types of inertia based on the structure is classified in two. So the first is state of rest. Inertia, state of rest. If something is in resting position, it will remain as it is. An object in the state of rest cannot change its state of rest due to its inherent property. This property is called as the inertia of the state of rest. Okay, suppose you are sitting in a car or a bus. In that case, the driver comes up, sits and starts the vehicle. But your body is not ready to change its state of rest. It is sitting still without moving. And when the bus starts, you get a jerk backside. Why? Because your body is not ready to move. It is in the rest position and force is applied to move it. So first thing that happens is you get a jerk in the backside. Now, inertia of motion. You consider the same example here also. You are sitting in a bus and the bus is moving, already moving on the road. And suddenly the driver applies the brake. Your body is not ready to stop. Body is in motion, but the bus stopped. So you get a forward jerk. You bend forward. Why? Because your body wants to move again. But the bus has stopped, so it's not going to move. So therefore, you get a forward jerk there. The inherent property of an object due to which its state of motion cannot change is called as inertia of motion. For example, a revolving electric fan continues to revolve even after it is switched off. Passengers sitting in the running bus get a jerk in the forward direction if the bus suddenly is going to stop. So these are certain examples of inertia of motion. And the last one is directional inertia. Third type of inertia is directional inertia. Here, the inherent property of an object due to which the object cannot change the direction of its motion is called as directional inertia. Here you see, for example, if a vehicle in motion along a straight line suddenly takes a turn. For a long time, you are moving in a straight line, but suddenly a sharp curve is there and it suddenly takes a turn. The passengers sitting in it are thrown in the opposite direction of the direction of turning. Now, straightway the vehicle is moving, and suddenly there is a sharp curve, and the vehicle wants to turn here. In that case, what will happen? When it will take a sharp curve, the passengers inside will be thrown away in from the direction where we are taking a curve. Okay, they will be thrown away from the direction from where the vehicle is going to take a turn. So this is directional inertia. These three types of inertia are very important along with their examples. And time is up. Next class we shall discuss with the pressure part of this chapter. Okay. Thank you all of you. Bye-bye.